This is a hard thing to write, and a harder thing to say. This is a practice and something I preach, a song without rhythm, a victory speech. This is my body. I think I'll start with my hands. These hands that have touched the hearts of people who love me, bottles of alcohol I was too young to drink, notes passed back and forth from high school friends, 1,000 pens and the ink that poured out of them. These hands that held my first love, my first lost tooth, my anger in a clenched fist, a cigarette or two when time has hardened them. These hands that put to use the thoughts dripping from my brain. Let's talk about my brain. An organized mess. Storing away traumas I haven't said aloud enough. My brain holds things in it I have yet to discover. Keeps me in check when I am trying to check out. It is bad at forming good habits, but great at making people laugh. It has hid things from me, but it gives me comfort when I cannot find it in others. My brain has created a safe space to place all the pain that my heart has endured. Should I go to my heart now? Its beat has created my melodies, powered through betrayals I couldn't imagine enduring before. Some might call it a miracle, the way the damage seems to repair itself. And it's true that with time you may move on, but the leaps and bounds my heart has made forward is nothing short of a marvel. The trust I continue to find in people when my brain will remind me that I shouldn't trust everyone I meet, but here is my heart. The benefit of the doubt extraordinaire, reminding the rest of me that there is beauty in trusting. It holds me in a way no person ever has. But there has yet to be a day when my stomach hasn't held me. The thing I blame my insecurities on, the part of me that strangers frown upon, there is so much my body does that I don't thank it for. The way my stomach has held me in place when my head has spun and my heart has raced, this stomach has anchored me, created layers of defense and protection from people my heart would be fooled by. This stomach has taken a beating, from bad nights and bad food to actual physical abuse. I would be nowhere without it. In my stomach sits years of swallowed bad tastes, nasty words, all the things I bit back and held on my tongue until the acid devoured them, and don't get me started on my tongue. This shipwrecked mouth of mine with teeth like jagged rocks on a shoreline, my tongue has never seen a comeback it didn't leap to, a joke it didn't deliver, has never found a good thought it didn't let out. It defends me in a way only family could. Unwavering, even when I'm wrong. I could go on. Talk about these eyes and their hunger, my legs and their battle scars, my feet and the miles they've walked to get me this far, but the moral of this story is I spend far too much time worried that my body isn't enough. That my defenses and protection should look like someone else's, that my heart will never feel as deep as I want it to, but these words speak a truth I don't say often. My body has kept me intact. My body has adapted itself to situations that have made others fall. My body has been my home when I have not had one. My body isn't my temple, but I'm going to start worshiping.